topic, as you know, is emotional dis-ease. Yeah. Now, before we begin, I just give you one analogy. That a few years back, I had a carpenter working in my house. And it's an old furniture and he had to dismantle that and redesign the whole thing to use up the old wood as well as, you know, cut down on the cost. And there was one old nail which was really so, like, you know, hammered in that it wouldn't come out easily. Now, that is what happens with all of us. Our constant thoughts, feelings, emotions, they get hammered in so much. So over the years, you may even forget about that pain or that trouble or whatever, but it remains with us. And slowly, slowly, if we don't work on that, we don't try to heal that, what happens is that it slowly goes into, remains in our aura and slowly travels into our physical self. Yeah? So it is said normally that emotional, rather all illnesses are actually always more or less are a result of our feelings, our thoughts and our emotions. Even accidents, you would be surprised. Important thing is to understand this, that some illnesses that we have on the physical level, some are like, let's say to start with, could be birth defects, which are karmic, which we get from our past lives to the present life, right? Some illnesses that children that we see have, some phobias, some doubts, you know, which they grow with. So those are embedded in their karmic pattern and they bring it with them. We bring it with us to a new life, right? Second part is that one is the karma part, but some people will say, okay, how is it that we would simply hold on to an emotion and not know about that and fall sick? But we do that. We also know that, in fact, that for even if there's any hurt or pain in a relationship, let's say for an example, it stays in our mind for so long and we go over it again and again and again. And what we are doing is we are strengthening that thought rather than healing it. So over the time, we say time heals. So we do forget about that. But the thing is now it is embedded in your astral kosha or the body basically. So now how do you know that it is there? We don't remove it. We don't work on it. We don't heal it. And then what happens over the time, it slowly becomes stronger and it enters our physical cells. And that's how we have all this stress and we have the illnesses like diabetes and heart attack. It is not an illness in the way that, you know, something goes wrong. Diet is of course important. A proper lifestyle, a healthy lifestyle, all that is part of it. But still, there are people who do that and still have problems. So that is because we don't heal it. Now our body is always talking to us. It is telling us something all the time and we have to pay attention. We have to listen to our body, what it is trying to tell us. Though it's a physical body, but it is telling us. If we could interpret what these symbols mean in our body when there is an ache in a certain part of the body, if we can just listen to this and understand it and then work on that as to what is actually troubling me at that point of time or what has been troubling me at that point of time and then how I can work towards healing it, how I can change my thought towards it or how can I feel differently about the same situation or the same problem and then work my way to the positive side of that. You would be seeing that, of course, when you have an illness of any kind, medical aid is definitely necessary. You have to consult a doctor, you have to take your medicines or whatever is given out to you, but at the same time you have to work on yourself of wanting to know what is exactly my problem on the emotional level and how I work my way towards healing it and then coming out healthy of it. Pain and symptoms of any time of any kind becomes a trigger, a reminder of where we might be blocked and what we might want to readjust in our lives. Yeah. Now you may wonder, but how do I know? Let's say my ankle is aching. Now, what does it mean by an ankle is aching? I might have sprained it. I must have got hurt. Maybe it was an accident. How do I know that why the ankle, I got hurt on the ankle? I wouldn't purposely try and hurt myself now, would I? Would I? I wouldn't. So then how is it that my ankle has got hurt and now I'm in pain? How am I responsible for that? You would be surprised that at a certain juncture of life, because of certain emotions and thoughts and feelings, we actually bring that okay, now my ankle, it happens so that our ankle gets hurt because of that. And we suffer that pain. You know what I mean? It is not that you say that accident. There are very, very, very few accidents which are really, like you can say, really sorry that somebody has really got hurt without their fault at all. But generally, when accidents that happen to us, we create them. We bring it to us. We bring those situations, those kind of events, or those kind of problems to us ourselves because of certain situations that we are facing in our lives. That is what ankles does. It takes the whole body weight and you move around with that easily and you function accordingly. If your ankle gets hurt, what happens? You're not able to move easily. You're not able to carry your own body weight. At the same time, you are in pain, you're hurting, and you're not dealing with certain aspects of your life because your ankle is hurt now and you can't do certain things in your life. What does it mean when your ankle gets hurt? Let's say when you have a sprained ankle, you have a lack of flexibility for the direction we are going in. So it means you're not flexible in the direction that you're going in, so you have a sprained ankle. Body tells us that somewhere you're not being flexible about a certain situation in your life and you're not able to move on. So to avoid that or to stay away from it, at this moment, you have a sprained ankle. You know, you would be surprised that if you really get into that, those who are not, I would not say very good dancers, but those who are just learning to be or growing to be, at certain point and they have a fear, they don't want to participate, they may land up having a sprained ankle, you know that? Or those who are climbers, till the time they become good and well and they're really well versed in their field. But it happens that they don't manage to get into certain competitions or certain activities because they have a sprained ankle. And it is not just them, it can be any other person. Like I may be an artist and I have a block and I have to go somewhere and do something and I will not do that. Why? Because I have a sprained ankle. There is a list of all the body parts that I have personally put together from head to toe as to every single body part when you have a pain somewhere or something which is not healthy for you at that point of time. You'd be surprised that if that emotion or that feeling or thought is there somewhere in the background or something in the past which has triggered that and now it is there with you. Another thing about pain and illness is that normally when we generally meet people, they have it in their aura. And if you are really close to them, we pick up that unknowingly. And then we don't cleanse ourselves and we carry it with us. Those who are empaths, you know what I'm talking about. Is it empaths? They are empathic. Means when they are so sensitive to other people's energy fields and their auras that when they sit next to them, whatever they are going through emotionally or even a physical pain, they can pick that up. So empaths pick up those from other people. Now, if you're not aware of that, you may carry that with you. The moment you are aware, you know, say, okay, it is not mine. I give it back to that person and bless that person with healing. Automatically, you're not taking it. As Buddha says, na, anybody can give you anything, but if you say no to that, you don't take it with you. So you have to keep that in mind when you meet people. When you go to hospitals, when you meet people who are not well, everybody is not well over there. You may go to meet one person, but everybody, the energy flows from high to low. So when you meet anybody over there, you'd be surprised that they're drawing on your energy. Sometimes you feel tired when you go back. And there's the people who tell, no, sit for some time, Mona, please don't go sit now and chat. Why? Because they're enjoying that energy which they're pulling up from you, whoever it may be. They don't mean to harm you or hurt you, but they need at that point of time that energy. But what happens is it drains you. Unknowingly, you may even lodge that illness of certain little bit into your aura then, isn't it? Now, accidents, as I was talking about, people go through accidents, major accidents. We say that it was an accident, it was nobody's fault. But somewhere at some point of your time in your life, you're facing some certain situation, and keeping that in mind, you are attracting that kind of a situation in your life and where those accidents happen. So it is just not a coincidence or something just went wrong and you just happened to be there and something happened to you. No. So it is entirely on your thoughts, your emotions, your feelings that you're going through every moment, every day, with every breath that you take, that makes a difference, which decides how healthy you are or how healthy you can always be. Of course, we have come to that stand that we have never known this, we have never realized this, and we have come to the state that we are trying to constantly repair of whatever is happening in our bodies. But now we have the ways. We can still be healthy. Shape, size, look, that is nothing to do with health issues that way. That is what generally we are. As far as we are healthy and we are happy. You know, even simple thing that some people have the knee problems, they constantly ache no matter what your age. Elderly people do that generally, but even nowadays you see youngsters have it. You know, some people's knee won't flex, you know. You know what it is means? You're not willing to give in to the authority. Means at this juncture of your life, there is something that you're facing and you don't want to give in to that authority, and then you're having that knee pain, which is you cannot flex your knee. And you can't extend your knee. Means you don't want to give in, and at other side, you don't want to stand up to that authority either. You don't want to face it. You don't want to handle that. You know, you want to be away from that. There is an illness called scoliosis, which means you have your spine it has a side curve. It is not like a normal curvature. It is slightly bent on the other side, you know. And this normally happens during puberty, and mostly it happens more to females. You know why? Because the female is constantly trying to please her parents, and doing that all the time, she's in that position that she's not able to speak up or do her own thing, because she would rather do things which her parents want and keep them happy. And over the time, they develop this spine, which is not a normal bend or a curve, but it bends on the sideways, you know, either side. It sort of tilts on the other side. So these are little illnesses. Now, because of that girl, that way she has no other illness. But just because she was trying to please her parents all the time, and she developed this. Nobody beat her up. Nobody put her down. She had no accident. But over the time, the spine bent that way. Now, when you have migraines, many people suffer from migraines because they have conflict and they have suppressed resentment. They are resenting someone so much and they're not able to show that, you know, I really hate this person. I really don't know what to do, but I can't help it but deal with that person. That person suffers from migraine very often, you know. Now, there are people who constantly complain about their illness to you. I'll give you an example as my father. He's always complaining. He's having some issues every single day. What happens? You're listening to that all the time. Unknowingly, you're thinking about him. He's a parent, isn't it? He's a family member. You cannot avoid that. He's sharing that with you. But constantly what happens? You are taking that. This is happening. That is happening. Again, how you deal with that? On the other side, my mother, no matter what happens, she said, I'm fine. Everything is okay. My mother was nearly on a deathbed. I mean, so I don't know how long the soul lives and what is their agenda. But there was a situation a few years back that she could have been a vegetable in her bed. But I saw to it with learning all this. I used to keep on talking to her, making her listen to me. Whether she liked it or not, lecture. She said, Pravachan, too much Pravachan you give. But believe you me, today she's sitting, she plays her games, Sudoku, whatever, she's watching TV. She doesn't have that much movement or ability to do things, but she remains happy. Even if she's not well for some time, some days, she still remains happy in her mind. You know, that is a difference. Like, I could have almost lost her 6 years back. But today, in fact, she's only, when people see her now, she's, oh, I don't believe. And some people actually thought that my mother is no more because of the ill health she kept, and people came to visit her for that. So you see that I could help her to change her thinking. No matter what, it is okay. Whatever happened in the past, whatever it is now, you can still be happy wherever you are. At least at this juncture, there are many people who are old, who are alone, who have nobody with them. At least you have me, you are in your own house, you are able to watch TV, you don't have to do any housework, you are on a holiday now, you have done enough what you could do for everybody in the family, now you stay free, now don't feel guilty. You know, sometimes she feels guilty, I am not able to help. I say, enjoy, you have done enough, now it is our turn to serve you. So she's okay. I mean, she cannot believe that she should be served. She's always thought of serving other people. For her, that thought was not, you know, welcome actually. She was feeling guilty all the time. And I had to bring her out. Don't feel guilty. Enjoy your life now. It is perfectly all right. You did things for people. Now let them do it for you, whoever it is. So that mindset, when it starts changing, your body starts healing. You start enjoying. Suddenly you do feel that everything in your aura, within your house, everything is nice. You know, that feeling slowly starts coming. But you have to work for it. You have to be aware of all those things. Like somebody in your house says, oh, you know what, I'm constantly having this lower back pain, you know, and then there is another pain which is added to that. Then you see whether they're having a financial issue or whether they're having a problem with a certain relationship and are not able to have a breakthrough with that. And they're really emotionally down, though they keep up a good front. You know, these little things, and you see within your friends, your family, it helps, you know, it really helps to know. First thing is that to be aware that you are having a problem on the physical level. Now, when you connect that physical level to an emotional problem of any kind that you have, so bring that to the fore. Okay, I'm having this emotion. What is it that, let's say, what is stopping me or what is making me angry? And you always come to know somehow, even if you're not admitting to anybody, you can admit it to yourself that yes, this is right. You may want to really murder somebody. Tell it to yourself. I want to murder this guy now. And that is what is coming in my way. Be clear. Be truthful to yourself first and foremost. That itself is a very first step of being aware that something is troubling you and you know what it is, or you're trying to find out what it is, even if you don't know right away. That is the first step towards healing. Now, if you believe in any God, angel, guide, friend, anybody, you really call out to that and say, and now I've discovered this about myself and I need your help and I need healing. At any given point of time, if you don't know anything or anyone, just call out to the Almighty and just imagine a green light, beautiful green light coming from above. And you're like bathing in that. At the same time, if there's a particular part or anything which is hurting you, you can send that color to that at the moment to be on the safer side. Because just now we are not jumping into all the colors and the chakras and all that. So this is just one safest way to start, because that is what I exactly did with my mother, and she loves the green color. So I say, okay, now, and many times she will just sit, okay, I'm imagining the green color, do not disturb me, you know. So it is so simple. I'm telling you that it is just a matter of intention. Your intention to heal yourself has to be very loud and clear to yourself.